Four occupied territories of Ukraine will officially be incorporated into Russia later this evening. Vladimir Putin is planning a special ceremony to sign the treaty at the Kremlin, along with an enormous rally in Moscow's Red Square.
Hours from proclaiming the largest land grab since World War II, Vladimir Putin tells security officials the process of forming a fairer world order is happening before our eyes. Part of that vision about to be formalised when he'll sign into Russian law the annexation of four occupied territories of Ukraine.
It has no place in the modern world. It must not be accepted.
The escalation follows a week of so-called referendums organised by Moscow and declared a sham by the West. The people have stated firmly their wish to forever tie their fate to our country, says the Russian Foreign Ministry. Not so for these Ukrainians fleeing Russian-held Zaporizhia.
We are not going to fight against Ukraine. We're patriots.
And for Russians dodging the draft, options are running out, with Finland shutting its borders.
The entry of Russian citizens endangers Finland's international relations.
In Ukraine, the war rages on, Russia pounding the city of Dnipro with missiles. An estimated 60 homes were damaged. Some have completely disappeared.
Less than 24 hours ago, a family home had been standing right here where this huge crater is now. Authorities say an 8-year-old boy and a 9-year-old girl had been sleeping inside the home when the missiles struck. They were both killed.
Yana lives next to the blast site. Her windows blew out and she briefly lost her hearing. Everything was flying everywhere, she tells us. I'm still scared now. Neighbour Elena saying, what is the reason for this attack on civilians? A question being asked by many here as locals join humanitarian efforts to repair what they can.
Reporter Karianne Greenbank is in Dnipro in Ukraine, a city that came under attack just a few hours ago.
Well, this is the second night of major missile strikes here on the city of Dnipro, and this time it struck a bus depot. You can see behind me, it's a scene of utter carnage here. Investigators have been combing through the debris, but we've been told at least 60 buses were completely destroyed when the explosion sparked a huge fire. Meanwhile, outside the neighbouring city of Zaporizhia, a Russian missile strike targeted a convoy of cars. Authorities say 23 people were killed in that strike, all of them civilians. These attacks coming as Vladimir Putin signs an independence decree for those Russian-controlled territories of Zaporizhia and Kherson, which paves the way for annexation in the coming hours.